in northern Oklahoma from Enid up in towards just outside of Ponca City. This is not severe, but certainly, hey, we need the rainfall, and it has just been raining here throughout much of the evening, just west of Ponca City from Kildare down towards Tonkawa and right over I-35. And there is some lightning within this storm right here. Chris Lee is looking in northern Oklahoma. He has his night vision camera turned on right now, and look at all the electricity within this. Again, you're going to see the lightning from time to time. He is driving right now, but you can see the sky lighting up there, and you can just certainly tell that, yeah, there's certainly a lot of lightning within this, a lot of thunder as well. Back over to Advantage Doppler 3D as we go in towards right down I-35. It's been raining over the highway. It is still raining over the highway. You will need to slow down as you move right across the highway here. Now, this will have that type of heavy rainfall where your windshield wipers are doing this just really, really fast, and even as fast as they can go, it's still not helping out a whole lot. As we go into Enid, the rain that was on the east side of town has now made its way in towards Breckenridge, and now we have another shower popping up just north of Vance Air Force Base, right over Cleveland Street from North Enid down to Enid. So a little bit of light rain making its way through Enid right now. That will at least help out a little bit, but this is going to be the area where at least we're going to keep rain in the forecast for this evening and thunderstorms, but no need to worry about there being any type of severe weather threats with this rain tonight in northern Oklahoma. Lows tonight, 54 in Enid, 58 in Stillwater. Cold front coming in here. It will still be windy, but again, a 20% chance of storms, mainly staying up to the north. 62 degrees at 8 a.m., 65 degrees sunny, and the winds are coming down tomorrow. And tomorrow will be a beautiful day as highs only climb up to 82 degrees. The humidity is low. The winds are light. The sun is shining. It seems like the best days of the week are always on Friday. Now, I love Fridays, but when the weather's nice, it makes it even better out there. So highs across the state tomorrow, 82 degrees here in Oklahoma City, only 79 in Stillwater, 79 in Enid, 78 in Ponca City, lower 80s in western Oklahoma. As we go into Saturday, there is a chance for some active weather again from 4 to 10 o'clock, a 40% chance of storms. The main threats within this area will likely be hail and winds. Again, as we look at the storm impact, hail and wind threat will be elevated. The tornado risk will be very low, especially out in western Oklahoma. As we look at our tornado index here from Woodward Clinton out to scale of 1 to 10, you're listed at a 1. Same thing can be said here in Oklahoma City and Edmond. Your tornado index for Saturday is listed at a 1. Moore, Norman, your tornado index listed at a 1 on a scale of 1 to 10. So a very low chance, as again, we're not really expecting much in the form of tornadic activity. El Reno, your scale, your index, they're listed at a 1. And the same thing could be said from Shawnee and into Bethel Acres and all of Pottawatomie County. So tornado activity not expected as we go into Saturday. Again, hail and winds will be the main threats. As we go into Mother's Day, that risk for severe weather, western Oklahoma and northern Oklahoma, Oklahoma City not included in this risk, but eventually these storms will then move into the metro, but more than likely not until early Monday. Strong winds, large hail, and the tornado risk will be elevated a little bit more so as we go into Sunday evening and into the overnight hours. So as we look at the storm impact for Mother's Day here, again, hail and winds, and we will bump up that tornado risk, at least elevated a little bit higher. 4 days away, we still have to watch it pretty closely, but it looks like, again, this is May, the most active month of the entire year for severe weather, and we are seeing those severe weather chances coming in here, but not for tomorrow. Again, a beautiful day, 82 degrees as we go into Saturday. Don't cancel those outdoor activities. Just keep your eye to the sky. Again, both Saturday and Sunday highlighted in red for the chance of severe weather. Temperatures near 90, chance for storms a little bit higher on Sunday, peaking on Monday, 80% chance. Again, the potential for some severe weather, ending Tuesday 70 degrees. And then look at the drop in temperatures. Next week is going to be a beautiful week after the rain, highs in the 70s. In Europe to date with the latest First Alert forecast.